in my head, right? Sweat my ass off too.
That was a good workout.
I'm sorry. Oh. My arms are hurting. You ready?
Whenever you are. That one guy was jealous of your arms.
Yeah, he was mine. Trying to get this shit back in trying to get back in the groove after however many weeks.
You'll get it.
You're getting there. You recording, right? You ready? Alright, we're about to kick this off.
Make a motherfucking scene. Turn it. Hey, check, check, run it, yeah. Run it, yeah. Check, what? Run it, yeah. Run it, yeah. Check, check, run it, run it.
What up, though? It's your boy, Kevin Levesque. Taurus. Fear. No bull, just bull. Baby, this special edition. 2 minute bulk. I'm not even sure if we even gonna call this 2 minute bulk anymore. Armageddon. Building bigger biceps, bigger triceps. We've gone through a plethora of exercises over the last 3 years together. A lot of you have seen a lot of this shit before, but you know me, I try to think outside the box, have a more unconventional have a more unconventional approach to making muscles grow. Obviously there's no special pill, potion, or lotion that you can have outside of anabolics that'll help do that, and you still got to put the work in. So I'm going to give you new approach, I guess, a new added addition to what I'm doing for arms to try and improve since my last show. We're going to start out with a bicep overload, all right? The exercise that you're seeing right now, this is more of a basic concentration, but we're really wanting to overload both heads of the bicep with a straight bar. Now, this is not a conventional barbell straight bar that you have. Most of your gyms might even have this smaller bar. It's a third of the size. Or actually, it's about the half the size of a regular conventional barbell. So basically, you're just gonna load 10 pounds or 10 pound plates on each side, all right? And you're gonna use your legs as the restricting factor. As soon as you touch, you wanna come right back up. And this is obviously not gonna give the full stretch that you would usually get from a standing barbell curl, where you can actually stretch the muscle all the way down, and then you can contract the muscle all the way back up. Basically, what we want to do is you want to keep it in a contracted position for as long as we can, and squeezing this bar as hard as you can with your hands. Now, obviously, you don't want a death grip, but you want to keep that squeeze and that tension on the bar to apply more pressure, all right, and more tension and contraction to the bicep. So we're going to do 20 reps restricted motion. You're gonna do 20 reps, all the way up, all the way down, all right? And as soon as we're done, this is gonna be four sets. You get the dumbbell that is most comfortable that you can actually do these reps with. And as you can see, I use 30 pounds. So basically, we're gonna do 5 reps on each arm for 4 sets. Now, when we start, we're gonna do 1 set. That's 5 on here, 5 on the left, 5 on the right. The very next set, we're still doing 20 reps with the barbell, then we're gonna jump it up. 5 reps on the right, 5 reps on the left, and we're gonna do that for 2 sets. All the way till you get to your 4th set, okay? This is a maximum overload on the bicep. By the time that you get to your 3rd set, which is gonna be 3, it's gonna be 15 reps per arm, okay? That's 3 sets, 5 reps per arm. Your arms are gonna feel like they're about to explode, okay? Again, this is a completely different approach, all right, to training biceps. If you're doing the same thing all the time and you're not seeing any exponential growth, you gotta switch this shit up, all right? You have to change your approach and your mental approach to this game. There's nothing wrong with thinking outside the box and doing things a little bit different than what you've done before, okay? So, when we're done with that, that's 4 sets. We're gonna jump over the bike to triceps, all right? And you're gonna see me on the Smith machine. A lot of you are gonna knock the Smith machine, but don't knock it. I've said this ever since I've been here. Don't knock this shit till you try it. All right, guys, so what we're gonna do is we are gonna do skull crushes, 1 set of 20 on the Smith machine with straps. And the reason why I'm using straps is because, one, I have a problem with my hand grip strength. And that is from years and years of doing truck work. My hands have taken a beating. Some of you that do not have grip strength, you can use this to also assist in that area. And again, this will help eliminate some of that elbow and tension pain that some of you experience during skull crushers with barbells or doing skull crushers with dumbbells. A lot of us fend away from it because of that particular reason. So, what you're gonna need is two straps, and you're gonna need them on that Smith machine. Basically, I just weave the straps through the Smith machine, and I grab the hand, the long end of the strap, okay? You're gonna need an incline bench, and basically, I just use 25 pound plates. All right, so what we're gonna do here, we're gonna come down and back up, not full extension, but you wanna go down, come back up, until you feel a full contraction in your tricep, all right? We're gonna do this in an incline position. And again, you're gonna notice that your grip strength is gonna start to give, but you have to grip the shit out of that strap to hold this up. And when you get that, when you get to the top of the range of motion, you're gonna feel your triceps are going to pop, all right? That is gonna be a hellified pump. By the time you get to 15, you're gonna be ready to stop, all right? So basically, we're down, and we're up for 20 reps. As soon as we're done, all right, I get off of the Smith machine, immediately go over to the incline bench, and we're gonna do 20 reps of incline close grip bench, all right? Again, this is gonna fire up the triceps in a way that you've never felt before. Just dig in, dig deep, and push yourself to the maximum limit. The reason why we're doing two different sets is because we wanna hit the triceps from as many different angles as possible, all right? You can do tricep dips, you can do skull crushers, you can do dumbbell kickbacks, you can do a plethora of movements. Don't just stick with one particular exercise simply because you have three different hands on the tricep. And your triceps is what makes your arms look 10 times bigger than they really should be. All right, you wanna fill out these damn American Fighter t-shirts or whatever when you go watch UFC or whatever the fuck it is you're doing, you gotta work your triceps and work them as hard as you fucking can for as many possible reps as you can pump out for as many sets, all right? Obviously, you don't wanna hurt yourself, but you wanna do this overload training as much as possible on arm day. Don't just stick with the same normal routine. Get in there, get you a fast acting pump, and get in that zone and just kill it, all right? This is the whole purpose of doing several different exercises just to blow those triceps up. As soon as we're done with the incline bench, all right, on my next set, we jump over to decline, close grip bench, all right? Same concept applies. Hit the triceps from different angles, and I promise you, you're going to see a massive amount of growth in your arm, in the arm game. You'll start to bust out sleeves. As my homie CJ says, you like the sleeve hug and all this other shit, you want guns? You gotta hit this shit from different angles, guys. So, there it is, man. That is my arm overload training for today. I got a boatload of this shit coming for you guys this season. We're trying to take this to a whole nother level. So if you guys enjoyed this video, by all means, please hit that thumbs up. Leave any questions or comments in the comment box below. And understand, man, we're trying to grow as much as possible. Get in that zone, man. Get in that gym and kill this shit as much as you can. I'm not trying to be ordinary anymore. I'm trying to be extraordinary, just like you. And there it is, man. We're going to wrap this shit up. It's your boy, Kevin Levesque, Taurus. No bull, just bump, baby. Busting your sleeves out. Trying to blow them fucking triceps, baby. You see that shit? American Fighter. I ain't no fighter. I'm in love, baby. Make your hands all day.